we'll see Josh Allen and the Buffalo Bills taking on Kenny Pickett and the Pittsburgh Steelers.
The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports.
This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Buffalo offense ready to bring out their high-powered attack. And at the center of it all, of course, the rocket arm man in his fifth year out of Wyoming, Josh Allen.
Buffalo gave Allen the most guaranteed money in league history before the start of last season, and boy, did he justify it by playing at an elite level once again, taking the Bills to 11 wins and another division title. Along the way, he threw for over
into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick, and the Steelers force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27.
I really don't think you can fault the decision-making here, because your offensive quarterback, they really had a big week last week, and you're ready for them to go again here. Not the anticipated result, of course, but you definitely understand why they did what they did. That quarterback's been hot. You want to keep the ball in his hands and see if he can keep the magic going.
Now we get our first look at the hometown kid, rookie Kenny Pickett from the University of Pittsburgh, as he leads the Steeler offense out for their first possession. Pickett leads the Steelers up here with a fresh set of downs at their own 27. They'll start the drive with Harris, and he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down. The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. Pickett back to throw, looking middle, and it's incomplete. Well, this defense for the Bills, they were very solid last week in the victory over Baltimore.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Pickett in trouble, and down he goes. That's Gregory Rousseau getting in there to bring him down.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. He'll take it at the 42. Call it an even 40-yard punt, 7, though, on the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a 1st and 10. So here come the Bills out for their second drive. Now they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
Josh Allen, he says that he wants to continue to perfect executing the run-pass option. Looked pretty good there.
And he's put in the minds of all people trying to defend him that his legs create big plays. So guess who benefits?
His running back.
You no doubt about it, and we just saw it there.
These are his numbers from last week's contest. 12 carries, 67 yards, and a touchdown.
Just an all right day from him last week. He really didn't break out for the huge yardage he had hoped going in. I talked with him before the game, though, and he knows this is a new, fresh opportunity. He's put last week behind him, and his focus, getting some extra yardage with every carry he receives this week. A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. Now Allen. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he is going to have a Bills first down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 2. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. Down right around the 25. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. The Bills at 3-1 here through their first 4 games. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. To the air, Allen. Man open, here is Crowder. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. They run here with Singletary. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Devin Singletary with his 6th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Bills get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it was finished off by a Devin Singletary touchdown run. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their 2nd offensive possession.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Pickett. Over the middle, complete. It's Harris. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. So a roughing the passer penalty there, CD.
And we know that these pass rushers love to get after rookie quarterbacks, but they've still got to do it within the scope of the rules. And that time, the hit came just a little bit too late. And the official won't even think twice about pulling this flag on that one.
Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. 49. On 2nd down, this is Harris. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
I really like the vision he displayed on that play, because he saw there wasn't a lane to completely break off a huge gain. So he found where there was the most space and got what he could. A nice, dirty run that's a positive play for the offense.
And he's brought down here just outside of the 20.
Let's go, let's go.
Normally on 3rd down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the 1st down and then some.
And now a throw on 1st down there, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Harris running straight ahead. 2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And that's going to bring up a 4th down.
So Pickett is off to the sideline, and Chris Boswell is on for the Steeler field goal try.
Boswell's kick is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So from an offensive perspective, at least able to get on the board here right in front of the 2-minute warning.
Yeah, now it's time to talk about complimentary football, isn't it? Because if the defense can force a 3 and out, there could be enough time on the clock that they can get the ball back for their offensive guys and maybe put some more points on the board before the half.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
So here are the Bills to take over. They got the victory last week. That was against the Baltimore Ravens, and they have the lead here as well.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 26.
Off the play fake, Allen.
That's caught by his tight end, Dawson Knox. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now they may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
A give up the middle to Singletary. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's
I
miles
am.
Away and smiling.
Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
And we all know how talented this guy is, who's calling the signals for him. But even the best in the game, they can struggle against a good, cohesive zone coverage. Can't find a gap in the secondary quick enough, and he ends up taking a sack.
So after the sack, Allen and the Bills with work to do on third and long. Off play action. Allen, they'll roll him out right. Uncorks one for Davis.
And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
Allen will look to throw for it on fourth. Isaiah McKenzie hauling it in. And he is going to have the Bills first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive.
Brandon, I have one word for you after that completion for a first down.
Lucky?
Analytics.
Well, the analytics say punt the football there.
So we're changing to analytics as we go, right? What a big-time play for them, and really took a big-time chance.
Yeah, big-time first half chance.
Well, the Steelers and Bills, they played in the season opener last year, if you recall, and it was the Steelers who pulled off a bit of a stunner. They rallied late, beat the Bills in Buffalo 23-16. Buffalo, a little bit of a rocky start to the season, but they would quickly right the ship.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
46 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
Devin Singletary's in his fourth year in Buffalo, and he's coming off career best in carries and yards, and he's hoping that 2022 is the year that Buffalo runs him to his first 1,000-yard season.
Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. No gain on the play there, second down. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, helped force the ball free, and kept them out of the end zone.
An incomplete pass on second down. It muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. Allen off the play fake. And he's got his tight end Knox for a Bills touchdown. A great play there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bills would extend their lead here just before halftime. Tyler Bass now for the point after. This one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it ends in a Buffalo touchdown. So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. Taken at about the one. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Well, the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. He'll take the knee, and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we've reached halftime here in Orchard Park, where the Bills taking the lead into the break. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you too in just a bit. But first, let's get everybody caught up with what's going on around the NFL here in Week 5.
Message received here. No need to wait. We're going to skip halftime and get right back to the action. Here comes the third quarter. The Steelers going to get the football first here, trailing on the scoreboard as we are back underway on EA Sports. Austin elects to bring this out of the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. And the Steeler offense ready to get going here in this third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now, they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
And this is going to be a Steelers first down as he'll take this up to the 38-yard line.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
First down, and they go back to Harris. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Second down, it's six now from the 42. They'll run again with Harris. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Go to work, y'all. Go to work. And they will elect to decline the penalty.
Everything turned out the way they wanted it to. No sense in even having to take that one, hence the decline.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 41 yards.
That was awfully nice. Hit him in stride and off he went. It was almost like the ball hitting him was like him receiving a baton and he was running the anchor leg in a relay race.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
Second down and goal. Pickett. And he wisely will throw that one away.
With a rookie quarterback out there, you're definitely going to find out how he handles adversity, because this one so far hasn't gone according to plan. He's got to fight through it and show him what he's made of.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Now Pickett. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So instead of forcing the field goal, it'll be first and goal.
Yeah, the force was trying to make something happen that just didn't need to, right? I mean, plays happen, let it go. It's over. Instead, he creates a penalty.
On the give, this is Harris. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Najee Harris, his first touchdown on the year. And the Steelers have got it back to within a score. So the first drive ended in three. This time they take it down and punch it in the end zone.
So that first drive felt like they were just gathering knowledge, didn't it? Just enough to kick the field goal on the first one. And the second time they put it all together and got it all the way to the end zone.
That's caught. And he's not going to get in as a try for two comes up empty. So they will be unable to cut this to a field goal as the differential remains five.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score. On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
He'll air this one out deep for Davis. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And the Steelers are going to get the football back at their own 17. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
And he's taken down. It's a gain of three from the 17 to the 20.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Throwing on third down. Here's Pickett. Got an open man. It's Pickens. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number three. Back now in Buffalo. It's the Steelers with the football, but trailing here as we get going in quarter number four. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. So good field position for the Bills as they come up first and 10 at their own 37. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got him.
And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave them with a third and about four more for a first.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Allen going to throw.
quick slant to Crowder.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
Singletary, they'll go up the middle. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. They go right back to Singletary. And he'll get this pretty close to a first down as he's tackled at the Steelers 16. 69 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. They'll try and run for this with Singletary. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. On the handoff, it's Singletary. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The six-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. On the give, this is Singletary. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Devin Singletary with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Bills are closing in on a 4-1 start as they extend their fourth quarter lead. An extra point by Bass, up and good. And it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it was finished off by a Devin Singletary touchdown run. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So here's Pickett and the Steelers, down by 12, a little under a minute 50 remaining. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. Now Pickett. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Here's Pickett. He's got Pickens complete, and he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And the Bills are going to get the football here at their own 40-yard line.
I think he thought he had his first read open on that one, but they were obviously ready for that throw. And that's just a lack of experience showing. Young quarterback stared his man down the whole way, and they were more than happy to sit on that route and bring home the INT.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Singletary again. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage.
All right, so they got that one, Charles, against the center.
And let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion, and sometimes you got that big guy on your nose, you got sometimes where he's coming at you at an angle. It's a difficult job for him to snap the ball and then execute his block.
Right back to Singletary on second down. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. And even 100 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
The Bills send the punter out as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Pickett to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
One final shot for Pickett.
He's got Claypool, and he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
Well, CD, for the losing side, they had opportunities in this one, but big plays just didn't go their way, especially late, and they have to suffer the L here.
It certainly felt like that takeaway, once it happened, and knocked the wind out of their sails, and they just couldn't get their equilibrium back.
So for Buffalo, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1, and they will hit the road next week to take on the Kansas City Chiefs. Meanwhile, for Pittsburgh, they'll fall to 1-4 with a loss. And